We need to take care of our veterans much better. But we cannot do that if we continue to spend the way we're doing. We spend $800 billion a year over and above what we produce. So we have to borrow that amount of money. It's called the exchange financial, the current account deficit, and that we have to borrow. And here we are dependent on China and Japan and Saudi Arabia to finance our welfareism and our warfare. It will come to an end. My argument is it does not have to end badly. It can end in a different way by doing what we ought to do, and that is live within our means, live within the Constitution, and return the rights of the people to run their lives to themselves. In this country, we all know we have a right to our life, we have a right to our liberty, we have a right to pursue our happiness, and we should have a right to keep the fruits of our labor, all of it. That means we would have a different tax system. It would be called the elimination of the income tax. And then we could get back to work again and take care of ourselves. It would be much better. But we have this ridiculous foreign policy now that requires us as Americans to be taxed, to go over and start wars, bombing country, destroy their bridges and their infrastructure. Then they come back and say, oh, well, we bought it, so we have to tax you again to rebuild the country that we just blew up. At the same time, our own bridges are falling down. It's time we took care of our own bridges and our own infrastructure. You know, the income tax is something we all know about and how it's collected and how we're guilty until proven innocent. But there's another tax that I've talked about and a lot of people are talking about, and I think they're going to talk more about it on December 16th, and that's called the inflation tax. We got to attack the inflation tax, which means the bottom line there is to get rid of the inflation tax, we have to deal with the Federal Reserve. We need to get rid of the Federal Reserve as well. And it probably wasn't an accident that the Federal Reserve and the income tax came in the same year. It was a bad year, 1913, unlucky for America. And it was about that same time, under Woodrow Wilson, that our foreign policy changed, because he was the one that coined the phrase, we have to make the world safe for democracy. Wow, it hasn't been very safe, and I'll tell you what, we need to make it safe for freedom, and we need to set the standard here at home. But inflation and the Federal Reserve System serve special interests. The people who get to use the money first have the best benefit. The government gets to use it, the banking system uses it, the military-industrial complex gets to use it. Anybody who has a contract with the government gets to use it. But then when the money circulates and multiplies through fractional reserve banking, the money supply goes up and then we get to use it, then our prices go up and we get hit with the bill. And that's what is wrong with that system. Last year, the government told us there was an inflation rate of 2%. Does anybody believe that? I don't believe that. So the reason they calculate it in such a manner is because, you know, they're committed to trying to keep Social Security beneficiaries up to speed and keep up with their current standard of living. But the inflation rate was more like 10%. So those who are on retirement or receiving Social Security actually lost 8%, and that's why in this country a lot of people are concerned about the economy as well as the war. They're concerned about the economy and the lower standard of living, because you can't live beyond your means forever. As an individuals, we know we can't do it. We have to pay the bills, and this is what happens to a country. When we live way beyond our means, the debt gets so big that we eventually have to go back to work. Right now, today, we are currently paying $1.4 billion every single day just to pay the interest on the $9 trillion national debt. I mean, think how much work has to be done to pay to produce that much, just the interest on the debt, and just think about where that money could have been spent if it would have been left in our own pockets. That's what we want to have happen. We as a country, I think, unfortunately, over the years have lost confidence in freedom. And I think this is what's happening right now. People are recognizing that we have a lot of problems. We have too much government. We need to restore the confidence that freedom really works if we just allow it to work. We don't have to depend on the government to tell us how to run our own lives. We don't have to have the government tell us how to run the economy. We don't need the government to police the world. We need the government there for the purpose that the founders instructed us to use the government for. The government is there, and the Constitution is explicit, it is there to protect our freedoms. One thing the Constitution is supposed to protect is our privacy. Today, our privacy is essentially gone. The Fourth Amendment doesn't mean very much. This has especially been bad since 9/11. But instead of protecting the privacy of the citizens, the government has turned around and they protect the secrecy of the government. They have it backwards. We need to know what's going on in government. There shouldn't be these secrets in government. We need to protect our privacy. Something will have to happen, and I believe it will be financial. And the indication now that the dollar is going down, the debt is exploding, our freedoms have been eroded, and we can't afford the foreign policy, something will happen unless we reverse the course. And that's what this is all about, is to reverse the course that we've been on these last several decades. Victor Hugo said once that armies cannot stop an idea whose time has come. The idea of liberty has once again raised its head, just as it did at the time of our revolution. We are going to continue that revolution because the American people will not give up, and they will not accept the idea that is government that has to act as our parent, has to be the nanny state, and has to tell the world how to live. We have to have the belief and the faith and the confidence and the understanding how freedom works. That's what America is all about. You know, the campaign has done exceptionally well. I believe these conditions that I've described have these views are shared by most Americans, that we indeed have problems. So we have these problems sitting there. We come along with some solutions and a program, and that's very attractive. And then we have now disproven a few things that the media have been trying to peddle. One is that, you know, after the first several debates, we did quite well in the post-debate polling. But they said, oh, that was because Ron Paul supporters know how to use a computer. There's only 36 out there that know how to do that, and they do all that spamming, and that's how he wins these polls. Well, let me tell you, I think there are more than 36 out there tonight. But it is true, though, the Internet is very, very important, and it has brought a lot of people together.